Okay, so in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at subtracting mixed numbers. So the method we're going to take a look at today involves taking our mixed numbers, converting them into improper fractions, to which then we can do the subtraction. And once we've done the subtraction, we can then turn that improper fraction back into a mixed number. We can partition them like we do when we add mixed numbers, where we do the whole number part and then the fraction part. But when subtracting mixed numbers, we can have the scenario where we're actually taking away a bigger fraction than we start with. So that's why for today we're going to take a look at the method where we convert them into improper fractions first. So for this first example, we've got 3 2/3, take away 1.5. So the first thing I'm going to do for this question is I'm going to turn these mixed numbers into improper fractions. So the way we do that is we take the denominator of the fraction part, we multiply it by the whole number part, we then add on the 2. So this first fraction, the denominator is still going to be thirds, so we follow that round, we do 3 multiplied by 3, which is 9, we then add on the 2, which is 11. So that first fraction would be 11 over 3, and then we're going to do the same for the second fraction. We know it's going to be over 2, so we do 2 multiplied by the whole number part, so 2 multiplied by 1, which is 2, then add on the 1, which gives us 3. So now we're going to do 11 over 3, take away 3 over 2. So now we want a common denominator, so we're looking for the lowest common multiple of 3 and 2, which would be 6. So we want to find equivalent fractions for these, which are over 6. So to turn the 3 into the 6, we must have multiplied by 2, which means we're going to do exactly the same for the top. So we do 11 times 2, which is 22. So that first one would be 22 over 6. And then for the second fraction, we must have done 2 multiplied by 3 to make 6, which means we're going to do exactly the same to the top. So 3 multiplied by 3 would give us 9. So now we've got 22 over 6, take away 9 over 6. So subtracting fractions, because the denominator is the same, we just take away the numerators. So we do 22, take away 9, which gives us 13. So the question says to give it as a mixed number. So 13 over 6, all we do now is see how many times does 6 fit into 13? Well, that fits in twice because 6 times 2 is 12, leaving us with the remainder of 1. So our fraction part to this would be 1 over 6. So our final answer to this question would be 2 1/6. Okay, we're going to do the same for this next question. So we want to turn these mixed numbers into improper fractions first. So for this first fraction, it's going to be over 6. So then we do 6 multiplied by 5, which is 30. Add on the 1 gives us 31. Then for this second fraction, we know it's going to be over 4. So now to find the improper fraction, we do 4 times 2, which is 8. Add on the 3, which is 11. So now we've got to do 31 over 6, take away 11 over 4. So we want a common denominator. So we're looking for the lowest common multiple of 6 and 4, which would actually be 12. So we're looking for equivalent fractions that are over 12. So to turn this 6 into 12, we must have multiplied by 2, which means we're going to do exactly the same to the top. So 31 times 2 would be 62. And then for the 4, we have to do 4 times 3 to make 12. So we're going to do exactly the same to the top. So 11 times 3 would give us 33. So now we're going to do 62 over 12, take away 33 over 12, which would be 29 over 12. So now converting that back into a mixed number, well, 12 will go into 29 twice because 12 times 2 is 24, leaving us with the remainder of 5. So this answer would be 2 5/12. So we've got some more questions we're going to have a go at now. Feel free to pause the video here if you want to have a go at these first, and we'll go through the solutions in just a few seconds. Okay, so for this first question, we've got 5 3/10, take away 1 2/3. So the first thing we're going to do is turn these into improper fractions. So for this first one, I'd do 10 multiplied by 5, which is 50. Add on the 3, that'd be 53. So this one's equivalent to 53 over 10. Then we're going to take away. So now we do 3 multiplied by 1, which is 3. Add on the 2 is 5. So this one here would be 5 over 3. So now we're looking for a common denominator. So we're looking for the lowest common multiple of 10 and 3. Well, that would actually be 30. So we're looking for equivalent fractions, which are over 30. So for this first one, the 10, we must have multiplied by 3. So that means we're going to do exactly the same to the top. So 53 multiplied by 3 would give us 159. Then for the 3, we must have multiplied that by 10, which means again we're going to do the same to the top. So 5 multiplied by 10 would give us 50. So we've now got 159 over 30, take away 50 over 30. Well, that would just simply be 109 over 30. So then turning this back into a mixed number, we want to see how many times does 30 fit into 109? Well, it'd fit in 3 times because 30 times 3 is 90, leaving us with a remainder of 19. So our final answer here would be 3 and 19 over 30. Okay, for this next one, we've got 7 and 5 over 12 minus 2.5. So converting these to improper fractions. So the first thing we do here is 12 times a 7, which is 84. Add on the 5 gives us 89. So we'd have 89 over 12. We're then taking away. So now we do 2 times 2, which is 4. Add on the 1, which is 5. So that one would be 5 over 2. So now we want to take these fractions away, so we need a common denominator. So we're looking for the lowest common multiple of 12 and 2. Well, that would actually be 12. So we want two fractions which are both over 12. Fortunately for in this one, the first one already is, so we can rewrite that 89 over 12. We just need to convert this 2 now. So we would have had to have multiplied the 2 by 6 to make 12, which means we're going to do exactly the same to the top. So 5 multiplied by 6 would give us 30. So we've now got 89 over 12. Take away 30 over 12, that would just leave us with 59 over 12. So now converting that into a mixed number, how many times does 12 go into 59? Well, that would fit in 4 times because 4 times 12 is 48, leaving us with a remainder of 11. So our final answer to this one would be 4 and 11 over 12. Okay, for this next question, converting it, the first thing we do is 3 times a 6, which is 18. Then add on the 2 would give us 20. So this first fraction would be equivalent to 20 over 3. So then the next mixed number, we do 8 times 4, which is 32. Add on the 5 would leave us with 37. So that would be 37 over 8. We now want an equivalent fraction for these. So the highest common multiple of 3 and 8 would actually be 24. So we want two fractions over 24 now. So for this first fraction, to get to 24, we'd have had to have done 3 times 8. So that means we're going to do exactly the same to the top. So we've got 20 multiplied by 8, which would give us 160. And then to get from the 8 to 24, we'd have to times by 3, which means we're going to do exactly the same to the top. So if we do 37 times 3, we get 111. So now taking these fractions away, if we do 160 take away 111, that leaves us with 49. So we've now got 49 over 24. We want to now convert this into a mixed number. So 24 goes into 49 2 times because 24 times 2 is 48, leaving us with a remainder of 1. So our answer for this one would be 2 and 1 over 24. And for our final question, we've got 7 and 2 over 9. Take away 2 and 2 over 3. So for these ones, converting them into improper fractions, we do 9 times 7, which is 63. Add on the 2 gives us 65. So that would be 65 over 9. Then for the second fraction, we do 3 multiplied by 2, which is 6. Add on the 2 gives us 8. So that one there would be 8 over 3. So now we want a common denominator, so the lowest common multiple of 9 and 3 is actually 9. So we want two equivalent fractions which are both over 9. Well, the first fraction is, so we can just write 65 over 9. Now converting this second fraction, we get to 9 by doing 3 multiplied by 3. So that means we've got to do exactly the same to the top. So if we do 8 multiplied by 3, that gives us 24. So now taking these fractions away, 65 take away 24 would give us 41. So that's going to be 41 over 9. Finally, converting that into a mixed number, 9 will fit into 41 4 whole times because 4 times 9 is 36, leaving us with a remainder of 5. So our final answer to that particular question would be 4 and 5 over 9. So well done if you followed along with those questions. And that's it for today's video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any topics at all that you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments. and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.